Remember your mercies, O Lord, and with your eternal protection, sanctify your servants, for whom Christ your Son, by the shedding of his blood, established the Paschal mystery, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. See, my servant shall prosper. He shall be raised high and greatly exalted. Even as many were amazed at him, so marred was his look beyond human semblance, and his appearance beyond that of the sons of man. So shall he startle many nations. Because of him kings shall stand speechless. For those who have not been told shall see. Those who have not heard shall ponder it. Who would believe what we have heard? To whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? He grew up like a sapling before him, like a shoot from the parched earth. There was in him no stately bearing to make us look at him, nor appearance that would attract us to him. He was spurned and avoided by people, a man of suffering, accustomed to infirmity, one of those from whom people hide their faces, spurned, and we held him in no esteem. Yet it was our infirmities that he bore, our sufferings that he endured, while we thought of him as stricken, as one smitten by God and afflicted. But he was pierced for our offenses, crushed for our sins. Upon him was the chastisement that makes us whole. By his stripes we were healed. We had all gone astray like sheep, each following his own way. But the Lord laid upon him the guilt of us all. Though he was harshly treated, he submitted and opened not his mouth. Like a lamb led to the slaughter, or a sheep before the shearers, he was silent and opened not his mouth. Oppressed and condemned, he was taken away, and who would have thought any more of his destiny? When he was cut off from the land of the living and smitten for the sin of his people, a grave was assigned him among the wicked, and a burial place with evildoers, though he had done no wrong, nor spoken any falsehood. But the Lord was pleased to crush him in infirmity. If he gives his life as an offering for sin, he shall see his descendants in a long life, and the will of the Lord shall be accomplished through him. Because of his affliction, he shall see the light in fullness of days. Through his suffering, my servant shall justify many, and their guilt he shall bear. Therefore, I will give him his portion among the great, and he shall divide the spoils with the mighty, because he surrendered himself to death and was counted among the wicked. And he shall take away the sins of many and win pardon for their offenses. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lectura de la carta a los Hebreos. Hermanos, Jesús, el Hijo de Dios, es nuestro sumo sacerdote que ha entrado en el cielo. Mantengamos firme la profesión de nuestra fe. En efecto, no tenemos un sumo sacerdote que no sea capaz de compadecerse de nuestros sufrimientos, puesto que Él mismo ha pasado por las mismas pruebas que nosotros, excepto el pecado. Acerquémonos, por tanto, con la plena confianza al trono de la gracia para recibir misericordia, hallar la gracia y obtener ayuda en el momento oportuno. Precisamente por eso, Cristo, durante su vida mortal, ofreció oraciones y súplicas, con fuertes voces y lágrimas, aquel que podía librarlo de la muerte, y fue escuchado por su piedad. A pesar de que era el Hijo, aprendió a obedecer, padeciendo, y llegado a su perfección, se convirtió en la causa de la salvación eterna para todos los que lo obedecen. Palabra de Dios.
Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus went out with his disciples across the Kidron Valley to where there was a garden into which he and his disciples entered. Judas, his betrayer, also knew the place because Jesus had often met there with his disciples. So Judas got a band of soldiers and guards from the chief priests and the Pharisees and went there with lanterns, torches, and weapons. Jesus, knowing everything that was going to happen to him, went out and said to them,
"Whom are you looking for?"
They answered him,
"Jesus the Nazarene."
He said to them,
"I am."
Judas, his betrayer, was also with them. When he said to them, "I am," they turned away and fell to the ground. So he again asked them,
"Whom are you looking for?"
They said,
"Jesus the Nazarene."
Jesus answered,
"I told you that I am. So if you're looking for me, let these men go."
This was to fulfill what he had said, "I have not lost any of those you gave me." Then Simon Peter, who had a sword, drew it, struck the high priest's slave, and cut off his right ear. The slave's name was Malchus. Jesus said to Peter,
"Put your sword into its scabbard. Shall I not drink the cup that the Father gave me?"
So the band of soldiers, the tribune, and the Jewish guards seized Jesus, bound him, and brought him to Annas first. He was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, who was the high priest that year. It was Caiaphas who had counseled the Jews that it was better for that one man should die rather than the people. Simon Peter and another disciple followed Jesus. Now, the other disciple was known to the high priest, and he entered the courtyard of the high priest with Jesus. But Peter stood at the gate outside. So the other disciple, the acquaintance of the high priest, went out and spoke to the gatekeeper and brought Peter in. Then the maid who was the gatekeeper said to Peter,
"You are not one of this man's disciples, are you?"
"I am not."
Now the slaves and the guards were standing around a charcoal fire that they had made because it was cold and they were warming themselves. Peter was also standing there keeping warm. The high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and about his doctrines. Jesus answered him,
"I have spoken publicly to the world. I have always taught in a synagogue or in the temple area where all the Jews gather, and in secret I have said nothing. Why ask me? Ask those who heard me what I said to them. They know what I said."
When he had said this, one of the temple guards standing there struck Jesus and said,
"Is this the way you answer the high priest?"
"If I have spoken wrongly, testify to the wrong. But if I have spoken rightly, why do you strike me?"
Then Annas sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest. Now Simon Peter was standing there keeping warm, and they said to him,
"You are not one of his disciples, are you?"
"I am not."
One of the slaves of the high priest, a relative of the one whose ear Peter had cut off, said,
"Didn't I see you in the garden with him?"
Again, Peter denied it, and immediately the cock crowed. Then they brought Jesus from Caiaphas to the praetorium. It was morning, and they themselves did not enter the praetorium in order not to be defiled, so that they could eat the Passover. So Pilate came out to them and said,
What charge do you bring against this man?"
They answered and said to him,
If he were not a criminal, we would not have handed him over to you.
At this, Pilate said to them,
"Take him yourselves and judge him according to your law."
The Jews answered him,
We do not have the right to execute anyone.
In order that the word of Jesus might be fulfilled that he said, indicating the kind of death he would die. So Pilate went back into the praetorium and summoned Jesus and said to him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?
Do you say this on your own, or have others told you about me?"
"I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests handed you over to me. What have you done?"
"My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom did belong to this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not here."
"Then you are a king?"
"You say I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice."
"What is truth?"
When he had said this, he again went out to the Jews and said to them,
"I find no guilt in him, but you have a custom that I release one prisoner to you at Passover. Do you want me to release to you the king of the Jews?"
They cried out again,
Not this one, but Barabbas.
Now Barabbas was a revolutionary.
Entonces, Pilato tomó a Jesús y lo mandó a azotar. Los soldados trenzaron una corona de espinas, se la pusieron en la cabeza, le echaron encima un manto color púrpura y acercándose a él, le decían:
¡Viva el rey de los judíos!
Y le daban de bofetadas. Pilato salió otra vez afuera y le dijo:
Aquí lo traigo para que sepan que no encuentro en él ninguna culpa.
Salió pues Jesús llevando la corona de espinas y el manto color púrpura. Pilato le dijo:
Aquí está el hombre.
Cuando lo vieron los sumos sacerdotes y sus servidores, gritaron:
¡Crucifícalo! ¡Crucifícalo!
Llévenselo ustedes y crucifíquenlo, porque yo no encuentro culpa en él.
Los judíos le contestaron:
Nosotros tenemos una ley, y según esa ley tiene que morir, porque se ha declarado Hijo de Dios.
Cuando Pilato oyó estas palabras, se asustó aún más, y entrando otra vez en el pretorio, dijo a Jesús:
¿De dónde eres tú?
Pero Jesús no le respondió. Pilato le dijo entonces:
A mí no me hablas. ¿No sabes que tengo la autoridad para soltarte y autoridad para crucificarte?
Jesús le contestó:
No tendrías ninguna autoridad sobre mí si no te la hubieran dado de lo alto. Por eso, el que me ha entregado a ti tiene un pecado mayor.
Desde ese momento, Pilato trataba de soltarlo, pero los judíos gritaban:
Si sueltas a ese, no eres amigo del César, porque todo el que pretende ser rey es enemigo del César.
Al oír estas palabras, Pilato sacó a Jesús y lo sentó en el tribunal, en el sitio que llaman el Enlosado, en hebreo Gábata. Era el día de la preparación de la Pascua, hacia el mediodía, y dijo Pilato a los judíos:
Aquí tienen a su rey.
¡Fuera! ¡Fuera! ¡Crucifícalo!
¿A su rey voy a crucificar?
Contestaron los sumos sacerdotes:
No tenemos más rey que el César.
Entonces se lo entregó para que lo crucificaran.
So they took Jesus, and carrying the cross himself, he went out to what is called the place of the skull, in Hebrew, Golgotha. There they crucified him, and with him two others, one on either side, with Jesus in the middle. Pilate also had an inscription written and put on the cross. It read, Jesus the Nazarene, the King of the Jews. Now many of the Jews read this inscription because the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and it was written in Hebrew, Latin, and Greek. So the chief priest of the Jews said to Pilate,
Do not write the King of the Jews, but that he said, I am the King of the Jews.
What I have written, I have written.
When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his clothes and divided them into four shares, a share for each soldier. They also took his tunic, but the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from the top down. So they said to one another,
Let's not tear it, but cast lots for it to see whose it will be.
In order that the passage of Scripture might be fulfilled, they divided my garments among them, and for my vesture they cast lots. This is what the soldiers did. Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple there whom he loved, he said to his mother,
"Woman, behold your son."
Then he said to the disciple,
"Behold your mother."
And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. After this, aware that everything was now finished, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled, Jesus said,
"I thirst."
There was a vessel filled with common wine. So they put a sponge soaked in wine on a sprig of hyssop and put it up to his mouth. When Jesus had taken the wine, he said,
"It is finished."
And bowing his head, he handed over the spirit.
Entonces los judíos, como era el día de la preparación de la Pascua, para que los cuerpos de los injusticiados no se quedaran en la cruz el sábado, porque aquel sábado era un día muy solemne, pidieron a Pilato que les quebraran las piernas y los quitaran de la cruz. Fueron los soldados, le quebraron las piernas a uno, y luego al otro de los que habían sido crucificados con él. Pero al llegar a Jesús, viendo que ya había muerto, no le quebraron las piernas, sino que uno de los soldados les traspasó el costado con una lanza e inmediatamente salió sangre y agua. El que vio da testimonio de esto, y su testimonio es verdadero, y él sabe que dice la verdad, para que también ustedes crean. Esto sucedió para que se cumpliera lo que dice en la Escritura: no le quebrarán ningún hueso. Y en el otro lugar de la Escritura dice: mirarán al que traspasaron. Después de esto, José de Arimatea, que era discípulo de Jesús, pero oculto por medio a los judíos, pidió a Pilato que lo dejara llevarse el cuerpo de Jesús. Y Pilato lo autorizó. Él fue entonces y se llevó el cuerpo. Llegó también Nicodemo, el que había ido a verlo de noche, y trajo unas 100 libras de una mezcla de mirra y aloe. Tomaron el cuerpo de Jesús y lo envolvieron en lienzos con esos aromas según se acostumbra a enterrar entre los judíos. Había un huerto en el sitio donde lo crucificaron, y el huerto un sepulcro nuevo donde nadie había sido enterrado todavía. Y como para los judíos era el día de la preparación de la Pascua y el sepulcro estaba cerca, allí pusieron a Jesús.
Palabra del Señor.
Gloria a ti, Señor Jesús.
Thank you. Let us pray, dearly beloved, for the Holy Church of God, that our God and Lord be pleased to give her peace, to guard her and unite her throughout the whole world, and grant that leading our life in tranquility and quiet, we may glorify God the Father Almighty. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Almighty, ever-living God, who in Christ revealed your glory to all the nations, watch over the works of your mercy, that your church spread throughout all the world may persevere with steadfast faith in confessing your name, through Christ our Lord.
Oremos también por nuestro Santo Padre, el Papa Francisco, para que Dios nuestro Señor, que lo escogió para el orden de los obispos, lo conserva salvo y sin daño para bien de su Santa Iglesia, al fin de que pueda gobernar al pueblo santo de Dios. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Dios todopoderoso y eterno, cuya sabiduría gobierna el universo, atiende favorablemente nuestras súplicas y protege con tu amor al Papa que nos diste para que tu pueblo cristiano, que tú mismo pastoreas, progrese bajo su cuidado en la firmeza de su fe. Por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Let us pray also for our Bishop James, for all bishops, priests, and deacons of the church, and for the whole of the faithful people. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Almighty, ever-living God, by whose Spirit the whole body of the church is sanctified and governed, hear our humble prayer for your ministers, that by the gift of your grace all may serve you faithfully, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Oremos también por los nuestros catecúmenos, para que Dios nuestro Señor abra los oídos de sus corazones y les manifieste su misericordia, y para que mediante el bautismo se les perdonen todos sus pecados y queden incorporados a Cristo Señor nuestro. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Dios todopoderoso y eterno, que sin cesar concedes nuevos hijos a tu iglesia, acrecienta la fe y el conocimiento a nuestros catecúmenos, para que, renacidos en la fuente bautismal, los cuentes entre tus hijos de adopción. Por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
Let us pray also for all our brothers and sisters who believe in Christ, that our God and Lord may be pleased as they live the truth, to gather them together and keep them in his one church. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Almighty, ever-living God, who gather what is scattered and keep together what you have gathered, look kindly on the flock of your Son, that those whom one baptism has consecrated may be joined together by integrity of faith and united in the bond of charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Oremos también por los judíos, para que a quienes Dios nuestro Señor habló primero, les conceda progresar continuamente en el amor de su nombre y en la fidelidad a su alianza. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Dios todopoderoso y eterno, que confiaste tus promesas a Abraham y su descendencia, oye compasivo los ruegos de tu iglesia para que el pueblo que adquiriste primero como tuyo merezca llegar a la plenitud de la redención por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amen. Let us pray also for those who do not believe in Christ, that enlightened by the Holy Spirit, they too may enter on the way of salvation. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Almighty, ever-living God, grant to those who do not confess Christ that, by walking before you with a sincere heart, they may find the truth, and that we ourselves, being constant in mutual love and striving to understand more fully the mystery of your life, may be made more perfect witnesses to your love in the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Oremos también por los que no conocen a Dios, para que buscando con sinceridad todo lo que es recto, merezcan llegar hasta Él. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Dios todopoderoso y eterno, que criaste a todos los hombres para que deseándote tú busquen y para que al encontrarte descansen en ti, concédenos que en medio de las dificultades de este mundo, al ver los signos de tu amor y el testimonio de las buenas obras de los creyentes, todos los hombres se alegren al confesarte como único Dios verdadero y Padre de todos, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Let us pray also for those in public office, that our God and Lord may direct their minds and hearts according to his will, for the true peace and freedom of all. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Almighty, ever-living God, in whose hand lies every human heart and the rights of peoples, look with favor, we pray, on those who govern with authority over us, that throughout the whole world, the prosperity of peoples, the assurance of peace, and freedom of religion may, through your gift, be made secure. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Oremos, hermanos muy queridos, a Dios Padre Todopoderoso, para que libre al mundo de todos sus errores, aleje las enfermedades, alimente a los que tienen hambre, libere a los encarcelados y haga justicia a los oprimidos. Conceda seguridad a los que viajan, un buen retorno a los que se hallan lejos del hogar, la salud a los enfermos y la salvación a los moribundos. Let us kneel. Let us stand.
Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, consuelo de los afligidos y fortaleza de los que sufren, escucha a los que te invocan en su tribulación, para que todos experimenten en sus necesidades la alegría de tu misericordia, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Behold the wood of the cross, on which hung the salvation of the world. Come, let us miren el árbol de la cruz, donde estuvo clavado el Salvador del mundo. Vengan y adoremos. Behold the wood of the cross, on which hung the salvation of the world. Come, let us adore.
We invite you to all come forward to adore the cross using the same path by which you come to communion. It is appropriate to adore the cross with a bow, a genuflection, or a touch. Please refrain from kissing the cross. Invitamos a todos a pasar al frente para adorar la cruz por el mismo camino que usan para comulgar. Es apropiado adorar la cruz con una reverencia, una genuflexión o un toque. Por favor, abstengan de besar la cruz.
We should glory.
At our Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say in our own language, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who have restored us to life by the blessed death and resurrection of your Christ, preserve in us the work of your mercy, that by partaking of this mystery, we may have a life unceasingly devoted to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May abundant blessing, O Lord, we pray, descend upon your people who have honored the death of your Son in the hope of their resurrection. May pardon come, comfort be given, holy faith increase, and everlasting redemption be made secure through Christ our Lord.
Amen.